Hi everyone, Syed here. Today I'm going to teach you how to design an iPad mockup in PowerPoint. First, let's check it out. In this tutorial, you'll discover how to create a captivating iPad mockup and even how to embed a video inside the iPad. This is just one example of the incredible PowerPoint template I have designed recently. This template has 100 unique slides and each packed with features to help you deliver a truly impactful presentation. It's designed with modern features and is fully customizable to suit your brand. You'll find stunning infographics, engaging visuals, and layouts that simplify complex information. It grabs your audience's attention and leave a lasting impression. Elevate your next presentation with this exceptional template. The download link is in the description. Alright, let's start the tutorial. Let's start by drawing a rounded rectangle. Set its height to 6.5 and width to 4.6. Align it to the middle and drag this yellow dot to decrease its roundness. Zoom in a little bit. Draw a little circle at the top and then set its diameter to 0.15. Select both shapes and align them to the center. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and make a copy of the circle at the bottom. Set its diameter to 0.35 and make sure it is in the center. Draw a small rounded square inside the circle. Select them and align them to the middle and center. It is time to draw a rectangle. Set its height to 5.5 and width to 4. Now select both rectangles and align them to the center. Select the big rectangle first, then the small one. Go to the Shape Format tab, and in the Match Shape section, choose Fragment. By doing this, we create this. Since we don't want any accidental movement, let's select all the shapes and lock them. Okay, they are locked, and you can't move them anymore. For the frame, choose black color, and remove its outline. For the camera, choose dark gray with no outline. Home button, both shapes will fill with dark gray. Circle has no outline. But for the square, set a light gray as outline. Let me make it a little narrower. Okay, so far, so good. Now we are going to fill the shape with a picture. So right-click on it and choose Format Shape. In this window, select Picture or Texture Fill and insert your picture. I chose this picture on purpose because I want to show you when you add a new picture, it is always distorted. So you have to fix this problem in the Crop menu, but it is not active. Why? Because we locked the shape earlier. So right-click on it and unlock it. Now choose Crop to Fill to remove the distortion. I want to change this picture. Select it, go to Picture Format tab and change it from this device. I hope you remember, this picture is distorted, so you must choose Crop to Fill. If you like, you can adjust your picture and then click on the outside. Be careful not to touch these thick black guides. Let me remove the shape's outline. I forgot it. Anyway, it is time to add your title and details to the slide. I am using the Lotto font style. The download link is in the description. Let me add a shadow to the frame. Select it, right-click, Format Shape. Choose this direction for the shadow and set the blur amount to 30 and distance to 20. But what about video? Can I play a video on this iPad? Yes, but it is a little different. From Insert tab, click on the video and bring it to the slide. Adjust its size and position. Remember, the size of video should be bigger than the shape. This scale is not acceptable. So, always use a bigger size. We can adjust it later. Alright, let's send it back. Select the video first, then the picture. We have to use the mesh shapes option, but it is not available right now. What should we do? We have to search it. In the search bar, look for mesh shapes. You can see it here. Now select intersect from the menu. Okay, my video is inside the frame, but if you want to adjust it, it is exactly like picture. Go to Video Format tab, click on Crop and adjust it. It is time to animate the slide. First, select the text box and add fly-in animation to it. Change its direction to from left. It starts with previews and the duration is 1.5 seconds. Let me open the properties window and drag the smooth end to the end. Let's open the animation pane. Now select the video and add play animation to it. Let's see it on the slideshow mode. Okay, it is good, but what if I want to see a black screen and then see the video? To solve this, we can add fade animation to the video. Since I want to see the video after text box, I have to drag it to the second step. It starts after previews and its duration is 1 second. I want the video play with the fade animation at the same time, so make sure it starts with previews. Okay, let's see how it looks like. Very good, but we have a problem. I don't want to see a white background on the iPad. How can I solve this problem? The answer is so easy. Just draw a rectangle, but make sure it is bigger than the screen. Change its color to black and send it back. Your PowerPoint is ready. We designed this stunning PowerPoint so easily. Let me know in the comments what do you think about this presentation. Alright, it was all for today's video. If you found this helpful, please like and consider subscribing. And I'll see you in the next video.